Welcome to the extremes of life. Harry from Kyoto will be your host. We all know that life is diverse. I'm right in the middle of Kyoto City at the bed of the Kamo River. Take a look around and you'll see all sorts of life. Trees, flowers, insects, birds, fish, dogs, and finally, us. Next time you commute to work or to school, take a minute and look around and realize how life is flourishing in your environment. I'm in Massachusetts, in the United States, in the forests in Northeast America. The trees here look totally different from those we saw in Kyoto. The trees here are adapted to, or are the fittest, to grow in this environment and climate. Now that we have an idea of how diverse life is, let's take another look, this time with the help of a microscope. You can see, just by the shapes and colors of these microorganisms, the diversity is just as wide as life seen through our naked eyes. Like with the trees, the types of microbe you find in a certain spot depends largely on the environment. And don't forget, these microorganisms happen to be single-cell organisms, and they are in direct contact with and at the mercy of the environmental factors. So these cells should really be tough. In this course, I'll try to help you realize just how diverse life is on our planet, and that the diversity is largely found in the microbial world. We'll also have a look at the extremophiles. These are microbes that live in such extreme environments, it's really hard to believe. The extremes of life. Hope you'll join us.